Delta.
Roger, you're loud and clear. I'll be monitoring this frequency.
36,000 Andrew, roger, you're loud and clear. How do you read me now, Dave?
Roger, you're still loud and clear.
Hey, roger, sir, we'll be standing by.
Secretary of State, other cabinet ministers headed for Japan, turning around, returning to Honolulu, We'll arrive there approximately 2 hours. Over.
This is Wayside. Understand those departing Honolulu are turning around and we'll be back there in about 2 hours. Is that correct? Over.
That is affirmative. We'll need all information to decide whether some of the parties should go directly to Dallas. Over.
This is Situation Room. Say again your last, please.
We'll need except advice so we can determine whether some members of this party should go directly to Dallas. Over.
Roger. You wish information as to whether some members of that party should go to Dallas.
Affirmative.
Do you have anything else, Wayside?
No, any other information, get a hold of as rapidly as possible.
All right. The Associated Press is coming out now with a bulletin to the effect that they believe the president was hit in the head. That just came in. Over.
President hit in the head. Over.
Roger. We will pass on any additional information we get from here to you.
Roger. Be standing by for your call.
All right. Where are you, Wayside?
Wayside is off the line. This is the radio operator, sir. We're returning to Honolulu. We should be back to Honolulu in about 2 hours. We will be in the air for about 2 hours into Honolulu, and you contact us on the ground there, operator.
I understand. This is... hold on the line there, Wayside. We have some more information coming up. Wayside, this is Situation Room. I read from the AP bulletin, Kennedy apparently shot in head. He fell face down in back seat of his car. Blood was on his head. Mrs. Kennedy cried, oh no, and tried to hold up his head. Connolly remained half seated, slumped to the left. There was blood on his face and forehead. The president and the governor were rushed to Parkland Hospital near the Dallas trademark, where Kennedy was to have made a speech. Over.
I read that. Over.
This is Situation Room. I have nothing further for you now. I will contact you if we get more.
Wayside is Roger out.
Situation Room out.
That is Bomber 13. Bomber 13 is loud and clear. Take over this frequency immediately with presidential emergency traffic. We have information on a Charlie 135 carrying the Assistant Secretary to State to Tokyo.
Roger, he is working, Clifton on this frequency, stand by one, I believe Clifton is on this frequency, there's Hickam, Hickam, Andrew, Andrew, 1-2.
You know his call sign, bro.
Fireman, Andrew.
Fine.
Right here, we have the aircraft already in a pass here, WTE, Dad.
Roger, what frequency and order is this call sign, please?
Roger, 86972, I do not know what frequency we're working at True Liberty.
Roger.
26000. So will you have WTE give me a call, please?
26000, Roger, stand by one, sir.
Hello, Wayside Communications Center, please. By any chance, can you get your secretary rough? Hold on, that, please.
What happened?
Liberty, give me 972.
Stand by, we're running the State Department right now. I'll have John give you a... hold on line. I'll have John give you a call as soon as he's done.
Right, your WTE wants him.
Okay, hold on line.
Hello, the State Department is talking to Mr. Salinger this time.
All right, well, look, can you get everything on there?
Okay. Okay, well, could you tell the communication side that number one is trying to get to 900 volts per head?
I'll raise two comms on for you,
okay, thank you.
Washington, over.
Roger, roger. Will they notify us time of arrival and location? Over. We do not have any firm words down there as to the exact status, but I thought, pardon me, Wayside, situation room has to have you. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
For Wayside, this is Stranger out. I'll get that information as we get to Hawaii, over. Wayside, stand by the situation room. Yeah. Go ahead, Wayside.
All right, this is Wayside. This is Situation Room. I read the latest bulletin. President Kennedy has been given blood transfusions today at Parkland Hospital in an effort to save his life after he and Governor John Connally of Texas were shot in an assassination attempt. Over the TV, we have the information that the governor has been moved to the operating room. The president is still in the emergency room at Parkland Hospital. Do you read me so far? Over. Wayside, this is the situation room. Are you getting the press coverage, or do you want us to continue to relay it to you? Over. This is Situation Room. Roger, new subject. We will have information for you on whether to proceed to Dallas by the time you land at Honolulu. Over.
Affirmative. Also, the determination
at that time
by the Secretary of State. Secretary of State
should
also go to Dallas. Over.
This is Situation Room. Will do. Get determination whether Secretary of State should also go to Dallas.
Situation room out.
Situation room is still on the line, standing by. Wayside, this is Situation Room. We have conflicting reports now, so we're not getting no confirmation. We will call you again. I have relayed your intentions and present position to the front office. Your office has the word. We will call you again when we get confirmation. Over.
This way, side out.
This is Murray Jackson at the State Department.
Yes, sir.
I talked to 7-2 a little while ago. Could you get me 7-2 on single sideband again?
Mr. Jackson, be advised that 7-2 is in a patch with the Situation Room at the present time, sir, if you wish to stand by.
Oh, that's all right. They're talking to them now.
Yes, sir, they're in a patch at the present time.
All right, very good. Can you listen in on this?
Not from this console, sir. No, sir.
I see. Well, what we want to tell the plane is that Undersecretary Ball request that the Secretary and all the passengers return directly to Washington instead of going to Dallas.
Yes, sir. I believe they received that message, sir.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Right. Oh, hello.
Yes, sir.
One other thing. The Secretary was supposed to call Mr. Ball when he gets on the ground in Honolulu.
Okay, sir. We'll relay that as soon as possible.
Thank you very much.
Andrew Sideband, Airman Gilmore.
Airman Gilmer, this is Murray Jackson again at the State Department.
Yes, sir.
The message I just gave you about Mr. Ball wanting the Secretary and all the passengers of the plane to return directly to Washington has now been reconfirmed by McGeorge Bundy, who has called and asked it and also said that he thinks the plane and all its passengers should return immediately to Washington rather than Dallas.
Stand by, watch her.
Right.
We give you to a patch for the aircraft at this time, sir. Stand by.
All right.
McGeorge Bundy at the White House. They request that the Secretary of State and all passengers aboard the aircraft return to Washington immediately. Over.
Roger, the message is through by Undersecretary Ball and Mr. Bundy. Advise that the Secretary of State and all passengers return to Washington immediately. Over.
That is correct. Over and out.
Situation room,
thank you.
Is this the situation room?
Yes.
This is Airman Human Sidebin. I have 972 for another pad, sir.
972 again.
This is situation room.
Stand by, sir.
This is situation room, over.
You have to drop out on here, you'll know what frequencies we're listening on.
I'll be on 1815
and 13,
and we can hold him on 18 for a while because we got
a
new Fort Garry up there.
Right, you got another one, a little bit lower one maybe?
Well, we'll drop down from
18 to 15 to 13.
How about triple one?
We can go there also.
Triple one lower?
Upper side,
then. Upper, okay. I'll tell them we'll be on 18, 13, 15, and triple one, all uppers, right?
Right.
Except this one, we're on lower.
Right.
Okay. 86972, Andrews. Roger, Andrews is going to be standing by in Liberty on 111 upper, 11176 upper, 15011 upper, 15011 upper, 13247 upper, and this frequency, 18027 lower, sir. Roger. 972, Andy, go ahead, sir.
Okay, for Alpha Juliet 3 in the Air Force Command Post, Victor Charlie 137, permission number 13999, arriving Honolulu, 22 diagonal, 20260 Zulu, ETD 2115 Zulu for Andrews.
86972, Andy, Roger, copy it all, and standing by, sir.
Okay, and we'll be on the frequency. I'll advise you when I leave it.
Roger, sir.
26,000.
Roger, give me a crowd, please.
Crown,
right out, 26,000, full patch.
Roger. 26 for all Andrews, crown on, go ahead.
Roger, crown, 26,000, will you get a patch with that Jerry Behn, please?
Roger, stand by. Duplex is on, go ahead.
Say a semi one.
Roger, stand by.
Air Force Command Post, Sergeant Phillips, sir.
I have Air Force One, stand by one, please.
Roger.
Air Force One, Andrews, give him a call, please.
Command Post, Air Force One, how do you read?
Dallas at 2047 Zulu, and we'll call a couple of minutes with block time for Andrews.
You have your approximate block time, sir.
This space out route will be 2+10, go ahead.
2+10, and do you have any patches on board?
Roger, full load, 20+.
And is Mrs. Kennedy on board?
Affirmative.
Fine.
I'll call you back, Command Post.
All right, sir.
Air Force One, Andrews, I have Santa Command Post standing by, sir.
Command Post, Air Force One, go ahead.
You stand by one, sir.
Okay, give Air Force One a call, please.
Air Force One, Santa Command Post. Go ahead.
Roger, you call me. Go ahead, please.
Roger, this is Colonel Hornbuck in operations. We have a request from the Chief of Staff's office to know if you have Mr. Johnson and Mr. Kennedy's body aboard.
Stand by one. Air Force One, affirmative on all those questions, right?
Roger, thank you very much, Op.
Air Force One, signal check.
Air Force One, and it's loud and clear, sir.
Yep.
Loud and clear, Liberty.
Roger. Scott, loud and clear.
Air Force One, Andrews, I have Sam Command standing by, sir.
Matt. Go ahead.
26,000, Sam Command Post.
Sam Command, Air Force One, go ahead, please.
Roger, Air Force One, are you airborne at present? Are you airborne at present?
Affirmative, airborne at 2047, 2047, estimated time on the mark, Andrews, 2305, go ahead.
Roger, understand, departed at 2047, estimated time of arrival, Andrews, 2305, is that Charlie?
That's Charlie.
Roger, Air Force One, Sam Command Post, clear.
Air Force Command Post, go ahead. I have Air Force One standing by, stand by please. Air Force One, Andrews, give Command Post a call, sir.
Command Post, Air Force One.
Go ahead, Air Force One, this is Command Post.
Okay, departure was 2047, and estimated clock for Andrews, 2305, and we're climbing out to flight level 290,
Roger, understand. You stand by one, please.
Go ahead.
Air Force One, this is the Air Force Command Post. If possible, request the names of the passengers on board, please.
We have 40 plus. Go ahead.
40 people, is that affirmative?
It's affirmative.
Can you tell me in regard to one and two, or the top people?
Roger, the president is on board. The body is on board, and Mrs. Kennedy is on board.
All right, can you affirm once again your takeoff time and your estimated time of arrival, Andrews?
2047, takeoff time, Andrews, 2305.
Roger, thank you. This is the Air Force Command Post, out.
On a call, please.
Air Force One, Air Force Command Post, over.
Roger, we'll be estimating Texarkana at 2100, we'll call us that time.
Roger, 2600, Command Post, copy.
Zero forecast you have.
Air Force 1970. John Day, need to know here on the ground if you have Congressman Thomas Songberry and Brooks aboard. Could you check this out for us, please?
Say again, Robbie, say again.
Roger, the delegation here needs to know if you have Congressman Thomas, Congressman Thornberry, and Congressman Brooks aboard. Could you check the floor, please?
Roger, stand by.
Air Force One, give me a crown, please. Air Force One, enters Roger, stand by, sir.
Crown.
This is Flight Ben, I have Air Force One on standby, please.
Roger.
Air Force One, Andrews, give him a call.
Charlie, four Andrews, give him a call, please. Air Force One, Andrews, give Connor a call, please.
Crown, Air Force One.
This is Crown, go ahead.
Okay, we need a patch with Surgeon General of the Army, Heaton, go ahead.
Please repeat the message, over.
Roger, we want a patch with General Heaton. That's H-E-A-T-O-N, the Surgeon General, go ahead.
Roger, Roger, it's General Heaton. The Surgeon General of the Army, over.
That is correct.
Roger, Roger, stand by.
Air
Force One, Crown, stand by, please. We're reaching the General now, over.
Standing by.
Command Post 11826000, please.
Okay, it's Air Force One, stand by.
Roger.
In Apache right now. Force One, Air Force One, Andrews on 15, I'll copy, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right, you have to hold on there in a long patch with the White House right now.
Roger, I'll hold.
Okay, sir.
Smokey 167.
P1, Andrews.
Roger, sir. Would you ask Peterson to give us a call? 18, sir.
Roger. We're on 18, sir. Is Peter up on 14 meg?
We can try him. What frequencies you have blocked out now, sir? 13 and 18 also?
Roger, and 15011.
Roger, these are all priority traffic now, sir, is that correct?
Roger, one of them is, the other one's a backup, and the other one's going to be busy in a couple minutes.
Roger, would you ask Pete to try us on 14, sir?
Roger, will do.
Can you hear me, sir?
Roger, can you pass me with Air Force One, please?
Who is this, please?
Sir, Nelson, Sam.
Sam, by you, be number three.
Okay, right.
Hey,
go ahead.
Right, sir, we'll call you back through command post.
All right.
Because this is taking quite a while, and no sense you're holding on the line here.
Okay,
sir, we'll be right back with you as soon as they get off.
All right.
Right,
landing
sir.
Forecast, showing again.
Right, say again.
It's a landing forecast, I want to give
you. Okay, sir.
All right.
All right.
Crown, Air Force One, still standing by.
Force One, Crown. Hello?
Air Force One, Andrews, give Crown a call, please.
Air Force One, this is Crown, do you read, over?
Roger, Roger, Crown. Air Force One.
Hello?
Please, please.
Air Force One, this is Crown. You were cut out. General Heaton is at Walter Reed Hospital. You'll have to stand by just a moment, or else let me call you back when I get him on the line. It'll take about a minute to reach him. Air Force One, Crown, do you roger, over?
Crown, roger. Try to get General Heaton, and in the meantime, try to get the Deputy Surgeon General. We will talk to either one. Go ahead.
This is Crown, Roger. Will you stand by or have me call you back, over?
Roger, this is very important.
Roger, I'll put an emergency on it. We'll get him as soon as possible.
Standing by.
Roger, Roger.
Air Force One, Andrews, Roger, still standing by.
Roger.
Andrews, I'll give you a call on 15. I have another pad. Air Force One, Andrews, Roger.
Air Force One, go ahead.
Air Force One, Crown.
Roger, stand by for a message.
This is Dr. Berkeley.
Roger.
Here.
Roger. Dr. Berkeley.
Did you hear?
Dr. Berkeley, this is Crown. You're cutting out. You're cutting out. You'll have to repeat, over.
This is Dr. Berkeley. I want to get in touch with General Heaton or General Heaton's deputy.
Dr. Berkeley, this is Crown. We're working as fast as possible trying to get the call through for you. He is at Walter Reed. We're unable to locate. We're still searching. Over.
The deputy must be at the general's office over in the main Navy building.
Roger, Roger. If you'll stand by, we'll try and reach him. Market, this is Crown. You roger. We'll try to reach each one of them if you'll stand by, please.
Roger.
This is Air Force One on 15.
Air Force One, Andrews, loud and clear, sir.
Okay, do you have another line in, New Crown?
This is Andrews, roger.
Okay, go ahead.
Roger, stand by one.
For Rick
Hi, can you give me the White House switchboard, please?
Thank you.
Forward, you still on? Ground, I have Air Force 1 for a patch.
Roger, roger.
Air Force 1, Andrews, ground is on. Go ahead, sir.
Air Force 1, Andrews,
crown,
come in.
Air Force 1, Andrews, crown is on. Go ahead, sir.
Roger, roger, locate him.
The guy's just calling.
Air Force 1,
Air Force 1, Andrews, now copy Andrews, sir. Air Force 1, Andrews, 1-5, now copy Andrews. Andrews, you're transmitting 1-3, sir.
Roger, roger. How about the patch into crown, please?
Roger, crown is on. Would you give him a call, sir?
Break crown, Air Force 1. Would you get hold of Duplex for us, please?
Roger, roger. Duplex is on the line. Go ahead.
That's just a Duplex, Jerry.
God interferes. Can you check me lower sideband 1-5? 1-5 lower.
1-5, 1-5 lower.
Roger. This frequency lower sideband. This frequency lower sideband.
Go down, we'll have to go down to 90.
Okay, stand by 1, I'll try to get him back on 1-5.
Go ahead.
one, Andrews. I have your party on. We're having trouble reading you this frequency. Do you read me, sir?
Air Force One on 15.
Air Force One, Andrews, reading you good and readable. Your party on patch is dropping way down. How do you read me, sir?
You're loud and clear now. We want to be again.
This is Andrews. I have your party on at Crown. Do you still want to talk to him, sir?
Roger. We want Mr. Behn on again.
Go ahead, Air Force One. This is Duplex. Air Force One, Duplex. Go ahead.
Air Force One, Andrews. Duplex is on. Duplex is on, sir.
Duplex is on. This is Dr. Berkeley. What arrangements have been made regarding the reception of the President?
Everybody aboard Air Force One, everyone aboard Air Force One, with the exception of the body, will be choppered into the south ground. The body will be choppered to the Naval Medical Center at Bethesda. Over.
The body will be choppered or will go by ambulance to the Naval Medical Center?
Will be choppered. Will be choppered.
I have called General Heaton and asked him to call the military district of Washington regarding this. Would you call him and cancel the arrangements to have it go to Walter Reed as we had spoken to him? I didn't know these arrangements were already made.
Say again, Doctor.
Body is in a casket, you know, and it will have to be taken by ambulance and not by chopper.
All right, I'll tell Captain Shepard that. Did you say?
Jerry, would you be sure and get a contact with Heaton?
Say again, Doctor, say again.
Hello?
Hello, say again, please.
Terry type ambulance.
Say again, Doctor.
He is standing by. They're having trouble reading you. This freak, can you check me through Liberty on 90? Can you check me through Liberty on 90?
Roger, going 90.
Roger, and stand by for a call from Andrews. Stand by for a call from Andrews, 90.
Air Force One, this is Crown, come in.
Clarify that later.
Oh, all right.
just a minute, please.
Surely. General Heaton, this is Operator at Andrews. Sir, you're on a radio fallback talking to the aircraft, and only one party can speak at a time. While Admiral Burks is talking, sir, you cannot.
Oh, very well.
And when he's finished speaking, you and sir can reply.
Thank you.
All right, sir. Just stand by. I'll go back on the back.
Hello?
Air Force 1, Andrews, you're General Heaton to call at this time. Go ahead, sir.
General Heaton.
I read you, Admiral Berkeley.
Over. Hold for a minute, please. General Clifton here.
Thank you.
Air Force One Andrew, staying in your last transmission.
Duplex,
Air Force One Andrews, give your party a call.
Duplex, this is Watchman, over.
Go ahead, Watchman, this is Duplex, over.
Duplex, this is Watchman. I understand that you have a crane that is really wearing type ambulance taking this entity to Bethesda. Is this correct, over?
Watchman, it has been arranged to helicopter the body to Bethesda. Over.
This is Watchman. That's okay if it isn't after dark. What about the First Lady? Over.
Everybody else aboard, arrangements have been made to helicopter into the south ground.
This is Watchman. Helicopter operation will work is when we have a very heavy casket, over.
According to witness, yes.
This is Watchman. Don't take a chance on that. Also have a mortuary type ambulance stand by in case the helicopter doesn't work.
That's affirmative.
Instructions for you, over.
That's affirmative, I received.
Now, some other instructions. Listen carefully. We need a ramp. A normal ramp was set up at the front of the aircraft on the right-hand side, just behind the pilot's cabin in the galley. We are going to take the First Lady off by that route. Over. Do you understand?
I receive affirmative.
Aye. Also, on the right here. The left rear of the aircraft, where we usually dismount, debark. We may need a forklift rather than a ramp. Such a thing that is too awkward. We may need a platform to walk out on and a forklift to put it on. Is that possible? Over.
Say again, Watchman.
I say again. Casket is in the rear compartment. Suggest, because it is so heavy, that we have a forklift back there to remove the casket. But if this is too awkward, we can go along with a normal ramp. Several men, over.
Affirmative, we will try for the forklift.
Right. Next item. Duplex, next item. The press, according to Johnson. Press is to have its normal little fence at Andrews Field, and he is going there by helicopter to the White House. Over.
Say again, Watchman. Say again, please. Watchman, this is Duplex. Say again.
Little fence for the press. The normal little corral. And it'll have to be front of the aircraft, but that's where the President Johnson will come off, okay?
Watchman, this is Duplex. Will you say that all over again, please? You were breaking.
Duplex, this is Watchman. I say again. On the right front, ramp for Mrs. Duplex. On the left rear, if possible, a fourth lift for the casket. And on the left front, here is the pilot. Normal ramp. Over.
Say again, Watchman, you're breaking.
I got that on the left front.
Yeah, I got that.
Normal press ramp for President Johnson.
It's on the left front.
The left front is right behind the pilot. All right.
Did everybody get that clear? Over.
That is affirmative.
Okay. 4-1, Roy Kellerman would like to talk to you. Over.
Watchman, this is Duplex. Stand by 1. Are you there? Watchman, this is Duplex.
Duplex, this is Watchman. Over, go ahead.
Watchman, should the Secretary of Defense and others be at Andrews on your arrival?
No, I am about to... Oh, negative. I have come to call the White House. President Johnson wants to meet White House staff, leadership of Congress,
and as many of the cabinet members as possible at the White House as soon as we get there. Approximately 18:30. 18:30, over.
Will you say that again, please? I got the...
You got it?
Right. Okay, I'll get it.
President Johnson is supposed to meet as many of the cabinet members as they have at the White House at 18:30.
Okay.
You didn't get it all. White House staff, the members of the White House staff, also the leadership of Congress, also all the cabinet members available at the White House from 8:30 over.
That is affirmative, Watchman. That is affirmative.
Repeat that to me. Over.
All the leaders of Congress, as many cabinet members as possible at the White House at 18:30.
The key members of the White House staff, that is Sorensen, Grundy, etc.
That is correct.
Okay. 18. Just hold one for Kellerman. Over.
Roger.
Digest, this is Crown. Now you are breaking, you are breaking.
Air Force One, this is Andrew. Sir, can you change positions? You've got a bad position there on the set.
Next.
Digest, digest. This is Duplex. Say again. You read that?
Negative.
That's repeated, huh? Digest, digest. This is Crown. Repeat, repeat.
Crown, I'm trying to order lighthouse car 107.
I understand you're ordering two cars, is that a roger?
Stand by one, so we're going to see if we can pick up the mic up on the plane.
Air Force One Andrews, request you change position. You have a bad mic, you're coming in completely busted.
Okay, how's this?
Air Force One Andrews, roger, go ahead with your traffic now, sir.
Digest the Duplex, how is it?
Go ahead, digest, it's Duplex.
Again, I repeat. Three helicopters transport people to the White House lawn, okay?
That is affirmative.
Roger, okay. White House 102 and 405X for transportation to David Hospital, okay?
That is affirmative.
That's a roger. I am keeping, I will join Hill and his party to Navy Hospital, okay?
Digest, this is Duplex. You accompany the body aboard the helicopter.
Roger. Request, I was unable to get a hold of Payne and Bob Burke.
Go ahead, I'm received.
Air Force One Andrews, go ahead, sir.
This is Digest again, Duplex.
Go ahead, Digest, this is Duplex.
Payne and Burke at the ranch, okay?
Say again, Digest.
So Payne and Burke are not notified.
Okay.
Say again, sir.
That is affirmative, Digest.
Okay, Jerry, one more. Stand by. Okay, one more. Hover ship is on 6970.
Right. Go ahead, Digest.
Say again, sir.
Go ahead, Digest.
Repeat. Hover 6970, okay?
That's affirmative, I receive.
Do you have any questions? That's enough.
Not at the moment. If we do, we'll call back.
That's a roger, but hold on.
I got Captain Shepard on the
line.
Oh, is it? Yeah, he wants to talk to the aircraft.
Digest the Duplex, go ahead.
Go ahead, Digest, this is Duplex.
Did you call Dr. John Walsh in Washington and advise him of our arrival?
That is affirmative.
Okay.
Where does Lace want Dr. Walsh to meet her?
Dr. Walsh to meet her.
Where?
Say again, sir.
Digest, this is Duplex. Where does Lace wish Dr. Walsh to meet her?
At the White House when we get there with her.
At the White House.
Okay, thank you. That's affirmative.
Stand by. I don't have anything, but I think they want the line open here.
Roger, Digest, this is Crown. I have witness standing by.
I guess I can hang up.
We can get him, but there's another call here.
Digest? Oh. Digest, this is Crown. Come in.
Digest, digest. This is Crown. Come in.
Stand by, Crown. Air Force One, Andrews.
Dagger to Crown.
Air Force One, Andrews. Say again. Go ahead, sir.
Air Force One, this is Crown, come in.
This is Dagger to Crown, I have traffic for Behn.
Air Force One, this is Crown, repeat.
Xander is 90, I'll copy.
Andrews, I've been over here, sir.
Sir, Air Force Weather, he's still waiting to bring up Air Force One. We've been waiting now for 15 minutes. What's up?
Right, sir, we're running two patches at one time to the White House, and they're real busy. We can't get through to them.
They're making
arrangements to take the body off and everything else.
Let me patch him with Air Force Weather so he'll know.
Right, I already told him that earlier.
Weather's
on. Hello, sir?
Yes, sir.
Right, we're running two patches at one time to Air Force One right now from the White House, and they're making arrangements about taking the casket and stuff off.
Right.
And we can't get through to you. As soon as we can, we'll give you a call.
Okay, he needs that temperature before he gets here.
Right, sir. We'll get, should be done pretty soon. They've been on it quite a while now.
Okay, buddy.
Right.
Thank you, sir.
Right.
Andrews, Air Force One, loud and clear. Okay, stand by, and we'll have General Heaton come on this line and turn the other patches complete.
Roger, sir. I have Command Post Weather. They've been standing by for about 15 minutes. They'd like to get a patch to you. Can we run it at this time, sir?
Yes, go ahead with them.
Roger, stand by one.
Command Post?
Right.
Can you bring Weather up now? I got Air Force One.
Weather's on. Go ahead.
Air Force One, Andrews. Weather's on. Would you give him a call, sir?
Weather, Air Force One. Go ahead.
This is Command Post Weather, be advised of a severe weather area from 40 miles west of Greenwood, Mississippi, to 20 miles west of Blytheville, Arkansas, extending 120 miles to the east for tornadoes, tops 50,000. Want you to be advised of that. I have a revised landing forecast, Andrews, if you're ready to copy, over.
Stand by one, I'll have to call you back on it.
Roger.
Okay, I'll call you right back, sir.
All right.
You got one right here. Who's this, sir? Hello? Hello, Crown?
Andrews, I'm interviewing, sir.
Colonel Dorman, General LeMay's aide.
Right.
General LeMay is in a C-140.
Right.
Last three numbers are 497. It's a SAM, C-140.
497, last three numbers.
Right. He's inbound. His code name is Grandson, and I want to talk to him.
Grandson. Okay, sir, we'll see what we can do. We're real busy with Air Force One right now.
Okay, you don't have a capability to work more than one, huh?
Well, we're running Air Force One on two different frequencies. We're giving them two different patches at one time right now, and that's all we can do.
I see.
And what is your drop, sir? Are you off drop off the Washington switch?
Well, I am, yes. Either drop 303 or 79225.
79225.
If you can't work him now, it's going to be too late because he'll be on the ground in a half hour.
Okay, and what is your name again, sir?
Colonel Dorman, D-O-R-M-A-N.
D-O-R-M-A-N. Okay, I'll try to get back to you if we can get him right away, sir.
Thank you.
Right? Air Force One, Andrews. I'll copy on 1-1. Force One, Andrews, now copy, sir. Go ahead, Liberty.
970 on 90.
You have 970 on 90.
He's off the 2115. Copy that. He's off the 2115, estimating 2330. Relay to Alpha Juliet 2.
2330 for Andrews, and he was off. Okay, he was off at 2115, estimating Andrews 2330, Alpha Juliet 2.
That's affirmative, and we're going to copy his passenger lifestyle teletype and send it to you.
Okay.
What did he want on 18?
They're going to get 972 and give him a check and get his stuff, but I can't right now. I'm too busy.
Okay.
Righto. Copy me, sir.
That's your last clear.
Roger, loud and clear. Stand by one, sir.
Roger.
Hello, Sam?
Yeah, how do we stand on Air Force One patch?
We're too busy right now. We got weather standing by and crowd standing by and you standing by.
Okay, give us a call when you get through.
Righto.
Alright.
Bring up 6756 real quick.
Roger, we're up 6756.
Okay, we'll be standing by.
Roger, 970 Andrews, stand by one.
We also have Liberty come up on 56 also.
Roger.
Copy.
Your side interview, sir.
Andrews, single
drive, right.
This is 16 Air Force Command Post, Major Tribe speaking. I'd like to get a phone tag for Zab, that's November Alpha Bravo 90. I'd like to talk to Monument aboard that aircraft.
NAB 30, NAB?
November Alpha Bravo 90.
Okay, stand by one, sir. Air Force One, Andrews, good and readable, me, sir. Air Force One, Andrews, I'll copy, sir.
Somebody loud and clear, Ali.
Calling one check,
I believe.
To Liberty, 98.
Roger, Liberty, loud and clear.
This is reading a good readable. You ready, Andrew?
Roger. Okay, put me into the correction. Take this and relay it for me, then I'll want to patch it.
Liberty, Andrews, meet me landline.
Air Force One.
Air Force One, this is Andrews, go ahead.
Rick Andrews, Air Force One.
Air Force One, Andrews, go ahead, sir.
Okay, when you pass the command post, all people concerned is report time and moving up to 23000,
right? This is Andrews, Roger. Copy, we'll relay, sir.
Roger, and pick up that weather warning from the Air Force command post and see if there's anything to it, please. We just don't have time unless it's important.
Roger, stand by one.
Air Force Command Post, Major Petrus.
Right, can I have weather, please?
Just a minute, please.
Weather on.
Right, sir, I have Air Force One. He's real busy, and he wants to know how severe this weather warning is.
I have.
It's for tornadoes. That's pretty severe.
Okay, hold that one.
All right.
Okay. Air Force One, Air Force One, Andrews. Air Force One, Air Force One, Andrews. Air Force One, Air Force One, Air Force One, Andrews. Andrews, 67 out, copy, sir.
Clear, break
Air Force One, Andrew is loud and clear. I have a weather on here.
That weather is pretty important. Would you give him a call, sir?
Break weather, Air Force One. Go ahead now, please.
Be advised that these severe weather area is for tornadoes. Tornadoes is the severity. Radar reports top in the area at the present time, 47 to 51,000. Over.
Roger, and what area is this? I'm sorry, I didn't get it before.
This is for an area 40 miles west of Greenwood, Mississippi, to 20 miles west of Blytheville, Arkansas, and 120 miles east of both of those portions. It's on your flight path, over.
And 120 miles east of both of these locations, is that correct?
Right. You draw a line from Greenwood to Blytheville and 120 miles east of that line.
Is that okay?
Roger. Your new landing temperature, Andrew, 62 degrees. 62 degrees. Over.
62.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Can you stand by one?
Air Force One, Andrew. Say again and go ahead, sir.
Air Force One, this is Crown, come in. Air Force One, this is Crown, come in.
This is Dagger on Air Force One, to Crown.
Roger, I have freedom, I have witness standing by for a patch.
We'll have witness in 1 minute. Could we go ahead with traffic for Behn, Crown?
Roger, you have someone else calling Behn. Is that a Roger?
That's a Roger. This is Dagger calling Behn.
Stand by. Mr. Dagger, Duplex is on. Go ahead.
Dagger to Duplex. Messages from Volunteer and Victoria relative to activities tonight.
Go ahead, Dagger. This is Duplex.
You are aware that we will go to Brown for meeting.
That is affirmative. Go ahead.
Dagger to Crown. Brown.
Air Force One, Enders. Go ahead, sir.
Volunteer will reside at Valley for an indefinite time. I repeat, Volunteer will reside at Valley for an indefinite time. Victoria requests that Venus halt to Valley with agents.
Will you say again?
Venus should go out to Valley with agents.
That is a Roger. Venus will go to Valley with agents. Victoria will go to Valley after birding to Crown. You understand? Over.
Victoria will go to Valley after first going to Crown.
Okay. That's affirmative.
Do you also understand that for residential purposes, Volunteer will reside at Valley?
That is affirmative. That is affirmative.
All right, that is all the traffic I have. You will get.
Okay.
All right, sir. I'll take it. They're through it so far right now.
Hey, ground. Andrew's the ground. Hello, Crown.
This is Crown, go ahead.
Yeah, you got any more for us right now?
That's a negative right at the moment.
Oh, okay.
Right, can you transfer this call to the other airways here at Andrews?
Stand by.
Thank you. 8
995 Kilo Echo 68.
Yes. Hey, again?
Is it over as primary or is 1-3 still primary?
We're running patches on 1-3 and also 316.
Okay, we're holding on. Okay. We got 970, we're on a patch around track.
Okay.
Chris? Give me a patch on the ground, please.
Roger, stand by one.
Right, stand by for Air Force One.
Roger. Air Force One, Andrews, crown out.
Now, crown Air Force One. This is a message from Wing going to Slugger.
The Slugger is
to meet aircraft as soon as possible. If he cannot do this, he is to see Wing as soon as possible. As soon as possible, go ahead.
Roger, roger. Wing 2 Slugger, meet aircraft as soon as possible. If this is impossible, see Wing as soon as possible. Go ahead.
That is correct. Or contact him in any way feasible.
Roger, roger. Crown, understand. Any further? Go ahead.
Negative, and I suspect that Slugger is back in Dallas.
Roger, roger.
970. 970, Liberty. I'm all done now. I'll have another one in about 5 minutes.
970 Liberty, nobody is at home except the maid at Dallas anyway, go ahead.
Good.
Need a forecast for Andrews 0530, ground temperature in the works for 972.
Roger, we'll get as far as possible here.
Traffic park run. Air Force One, this is Crown, come in.
Request
from Victoria to cancel or ditch her commercial telephone. That is Volunteer and Victoria's commercial telephone at Valley. Could be temporarily discontinued and security lines to be put in. Just MACA personnel and on that, you understand, over. That's a roger, roger. Cancel commercial lines at Valley and install WACA circuits. Is that a roger?
That is a roger.
Roger, will do.
Air Force One, Andrews, go ahead.
Okay, give me crown, please.
Roger, wait one. White House?
Stand by for Air Force One.
Roger. Crown. Air Force One, Andrews, give crown a call.
Roger, Air Force One. We'd like a patch with Winter, and patch is coming from Warrior. Go ahead.
Roger, roger. Stand by.
Warrior, how do you read me? Over.
Crown Andrews, be advised. Warrior calling you. Warrior Andrews, stand by. Crown?
Only on duty, that is. Well.
From Crown, I have Winter now for Warrior. Go ahead. AF1 from Crown, AF1 from Crown. I now have Winner for Warrior. Go ahead.
Watch one, Andrews.
Warrior from Crown.
Hello, Liberty.
He's in patch right now.
AF1 from Crown.
Crown, this is Warrior. How do you read, over?
Warrior from Crown, you're loud and clear. I'm putting Winner on now. Do you, Roger?
Warrior
from Crown, go ahead and transmit Winner. Winner is on the line.
Winner, this is Warrior. Do you read me, over?
I hear you. Over.
Winner, this is Warrior. Will you please advise press that normal press coverage, including live TV, will be allowed at the base? Volunteer will make statement on arrival. Did you read that, over?
I read you clearly. Will you listen to my question? Is Mrs. Kennedy aboard Air Force One?
Winner, this is Warrior. That is a Roger, over.
All right, the other thing is I'm setting up a press section on the south lawn about 50 yards from the position of helicopter number one. Would that meet Mrs. Kennedy's and the President's approval?
They are not returning to the house. For your own information. They're going someplace else. I don't want to go in on the radio on this one. So there will be an arrival there, but it will be volunteer. Over.
Thank you. I will hold that information, and we can say something after you arrive. Hold it just a second. Let me look through my list of questions. Is it true that the body of President Kennedy will go to Bethesda Naval Hospital?
That is a Roger, but we are not saying that yet, over.
Well, we've already said it. I should have checked with you before doing it, but I don't think it makes too much difference. It takes a lot of, we should know it, and it takes a lot off of us by doing it. I was in error. Over.
So far as that press area on the south lawn, there is no objection to that.
Should that be live? Would we permit live? Yes, you told me that. Okay. Anything else?
And Andy, would you repeat that?
Anything else that I should know?
Wait a minute, you're breaking, but let me think about that for just a second. Would you please?
Okay.
The pool on this aircraft is Chuck Robertson Smith. We lost Bill somewhere along the line. We don't have AP aboard, but I have given them the statement of volunteer on the deck, which he will make at the airport. Over.
Oh, I understand you. Okay, over and out.
No, don't out on me yet, because are you still there, Winner?
Yes, I am. I'm here.
I think that we're going to tell the press that on arrival, hold on just a second, wait a minute, I've got Clifton here, he's trying to give me something, hold on.
later, he will meet with the leadership. With the leadership, did you read that, over?
Yes, I did read that.
Wait a minute, you're breaking badly. I cannot read.
Yes, yes, I understand, and I will announce.
Very good, Wayne. Now, wait a minute, there's one other point I'm getting from a question now that I want to relay to you. Hold on.
I did not hear you at all, Mac. Repeat. Repeat complete statement.
Read me, over.
Will you? I did not read you. Will you complete? Repeat your complete statement, your entire statement.
My entire statement I will repeat. They said that on arrival at the house, the president will meet with McNamara and Bundy. If Rusk is in town, he will meet with Rusk, but I think he is in the Far East, so it will probably be Ball. And after, about a half hour after that meeting is over, he will meet with the congressional leadership at 8 wait a minute, I'm getting a time on that now. That's 8 o'clock. He will meet with the leadership at 8 o'clock, at 8 o'clock. Did you read that, over?
I read. Now, is that bipartisan leadership or Democratic leadership?
That is wholly bipartisan, wholly bipartisan, over.
I understand you.
Hold one, and let me check any other information here. Is that, do you mind holding it?
No, go right ahead.
The request from AF1.
Crown, this is Watchman, over.
This is Crown. Go ahead, Watchman. AF1 from Crown. You were broken. You were broken. Say again.
Crown, this is Watchman. Please get Mr. Bundy on the line, over.
Roger. Stand by. Crown, your party on this end is on. Go ahead and transmit to him.
This is Watchman. Crown, please monitor. Mac, Mr. Johnson, but the base is on me. He told the Secretary McNamara at 6:30 at the White House. If Mr. Rusk is in town, fine for Mr. Rusk. If he is not in town, then we do not want an acting secretary. Over.
Correct. Will you tell him that the acting cabinet will be at the airport to greet him? He can bring McNamara and me in his chopper to the White House. Over.
That is correct. That is all right. We will do that. Take another message. Over.
Yeah.
Secondly, I told Gary Behn about a White House staff meeting.
Yeah.
There will be no White House staff meeting tonight.
Right.
There will be tomorrow. Over.
Correct. I have you. I have it. Let me repeat your message. Right. Over.
Under.
First, that the
President wishes to meet with SecDef and me at the White House on return from Andrews. Second, that there will be no other meeting this evening. There will be a White House staff meeting on call tomorrow. Over.
No, that is not correct. He wants to meet with the leadership about 7:30. Leadership about 7:30. Over.
Right. Does he wish us to arrange that? Over.
You to arrange that. Two meetings tonight. Back tomorrow on Monday.
Yep.
With the leadership about 7:30. Over.
Does he mean the Democratic leadership only? Over.
Bipartisan leadership, and I'll give you some names. Over.
Right. Over.
Of the house.
Yeah.
Carl Albert.
Carl Albert.
Dale Fogg.
Yeah.
Carl Hammond.
Wait a moment. Say that one again.
Leslie
Aaron. Aaron's? Yeah.
Are you listening? Over.
Will you take what I have for me, over, and then we can go on.
Over.
I have the speaker, Carl Albert, Hale Boggs, Leslie Ahrens. Over.
This is Watchman, and that is correct. I will now continue with the Senate. Over.
Right. Over.
Enfield.
Right.
Ready?
Yeah. Others. Yeah. Wait a moment. I have the first three. Over. Repeat, over.
Oh, sir, stand by, please.
Yeah.
Andy?
Roger.
Clown, this is Angel. Clown, this is Angel.
Clown, Angel. Post
it. Mr. Angel, would you, I broke down with Mr. Bundy. Would you check your Senate list for me? Over.
I have Mansfield, Humphrey, Smathers. Over.
Watchman. In addition to Mansfield, Humphrey, and Smathers, you want Dirksen?
Yeah.
Kuechel and Hickenlooper. Over.
Dirksen, Kuechel, Hickenlooper. Over.
That is correct. For about 7:30. Over.
7:30 at the White House. Over.
7:30 in the cabinet room. Over.
Tell the Vice President the cabinet room is under rearrangement, but the Oval Room will be ready. Over.
The Oval Room, it will be. You mean the Fish Room?
The President, I mean both the Fish Room and the President's study, and we will try to have the cabinet room, but that's a detail. We can work that out. Over.
This is Watchman. He does not want to go in the mansion or in the Oval Room or the President's study or the President's office.
Correct.
The cabinet room is ready, just put it in the Fish Room. Over.
I have you, I understand. Always in the West Wing, over.
This is correct, over.
I have nothing further, over.
This is Watchman. Now please, Duplex, about the changes so we don't confuse it. Duplex is Jerry Behn, over.
Right, I will.
See you in a little while, over.
Okay.
Air Force One, Andrews Air Force One, over.
Air Force One, this is Crown.
This is Warrior, the Crown. Warrior, the Crown. Crown, are you reading, over?
Roger, sir.
Air Force Command Post, Sergeant Phillips, sir.
Roger, Andrew, sideband. Would you give me Crown, please?
Give me who, sir? General Andrews?
Yes.
Who do you want to give a call?
The Crown. White House.
Just a moment.
White House. Roger, stand by for Air Force One.
Roger.
Air Force One, Andrews, Crown on. Go ahead.
Warrior, how do you read, over?
Air Force One, this is Crown. You're loud and clear. Go ahead.
White House.
Crown, this is Warrior. Will you give me another patch to winner? Correct. Another patch to winner, over.
Roger, stand by.
There's we're still standing by for Crown.
Do I have that pass with a pound?
Landers, we're still standing by for one or through ground.
Would you repeat?
Roger, we are still standing by for winter. We are still standing by for winter.
That's a roger.
On Anders.
Crown, that is Warrior, over.
Warrior Anders, stand by. Winter is still in another patch. Winter is still in another patch. I have a message for a radio operator on Air Force One.
Crown, who is winter on patch with, over?
Hello, Anders?
Yes.
You're still connected with me right now.
Roger, could you ring them for me?
Ring them again?
Yes.
Warrior,
Crown. Crown, give them another call.
Warrior, this is Crown. Warrior, this is Crown. We are having some difficulty in locating Winter. Would you stand by, please? That's a roger, Crown. This is Warrior.
Air Force One, Anders. Anders?
Anders, Air Force One.
Roger, sir. Could you give me a quick check on 9?
Just up there at
Carver. Roger, sir. Standing by. This is...
How about bringing that 13 Liberty remote on the coast and going back with it?
Liberty, Roger, standby.
Okay, and also, Andrews, how about relaying our new block dial at 23050 to Air Force Command Post and all concerned, go ahead.
Roger, sir, copied, will do.
This is ground command.
He may be out in the west lobby. He may be out in the west lobby, over.
Roger, stand by. Your warrior, this is ground command.
Forward, he may be out in.
Air Force 106.
Air Force 1, Andrew, is loud and clear.
Give me crown, please, in a hurry.
Roger, stand by.
Hello, Andrews.
Roger, Crown.
Roger.
Stand by Air Force One. Air Force One, Andrews, give Crown a call.
Break Crown Air Force One. Volunteer requesting a patch with Mrs. Rose Kennedy as soon as possible. Go ahead.
Roger, understand. Volunteer wants a patch with Mrs. Rose as soon as possible.
Mrs. Rose Kennedy, Roger.
Roger. I'll work on that right away. And also, while I'm working on that, could we have a confirmation? A confirmation on earlier transmission from AF-1 stating that the commercial telephone service, I say again, commercial telephone service for the Johnson residence should be discontinued with the direct lines to White House. Do you roger that?
Stand by one. We'll have to check it out.
Roger. While you're checking on that, I'll work on the call to Mrs. Rose Kennedy for volunteers. Stand by.
How about this 13 with Liberty? Liberty standing by, you want to call Melton? Okay, we'll put you on 13.
Roger.
That is affirmative. Confirmation on your request, go ahead.
White House, Roger, that is affirmative,
Affirmative, you have it correct.
Roger, stand by for the other party.
Party, Roger, for your message, and they're standing, they advise you to stand by for your party.
Andrews, I have a patch in the crown and I do not want it broken.
Sir, you're still on patch with crown.
Okay. Air Force One, you still on?
Roger, please stand by.
Roger, standing by.
AF-1, please stand by. We have Mrs. Rose Kennedy.
Stand by.
AF-1, have you got your party? Go ahead.
Stand by one, please. You have her standing by?
Roger. I'm going to put Mrs. Rose Kennedy on the line now.
Okay, Crown, we're coming on now.
Roger.
Hello?
Just one moment now, please. Paul, are you on?
Hello?
Stand by one now, please.
One from Crown, come in.
Crown, this is Air Force One. Do you read us, over?
I'm reading you loud and clear. I have Mrs. Kennedy standing by. Are you ready with volunteer? Go ahead.
Yes, we are ready. Can you put her on and I'll turn her over to him, over.
Roger, roger. She's coming on now. AF1 from Crown, Mrs. Kennedy on. Go ahead, please.
Hello, Mrs. Kennedy. Hello, Mrs. Kennedy. We're talking from the airplane. Can you hear us all right, over? Yes, Mrs. Kennedy, I have Mr. Johnson for you here.
Yes,
thank you.
Hello. Mrs. Kennedy?
Yes. Yes, 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 Mr. President. Yes, I wish to God there was something that I could do, and I wanted to tell you that we were greeting with you.
Yes, well, thank you very much. Thank you very much. I know you love Jack and he loves you.
Yes, Kennedy, we feel like we just have a...
Yes, all right.
We have made a decision, hence the son.
Yes. Well, thank you, Lady Bird. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Yes. Yes. Love and prayers to all of you.
Thank you very much. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Crown, this is Warrior. I think that is over. Is that a Roger, Omen?
That is a Roger, Warrior. That is a Roger. Mrs. Kennedy has hung up. Go ahead.
Crown, now would you give me that patch to Walter Jenkins in President Johnson's office, over.
Roger, stand by one.
And Crown, get somebody to come up on the Charlie set, please. Lever, the Andrews, FOSY, are you on 9?
Roger, sir, you're loud and clear. I still have WTE standing by for Warrior.
Okay, bring him up on 9, please.
Roger, sir, send my one.
Crown, go ahead and get him Air Force One a call now.
Air Force One, this is Crown, come in.
Crown.
Air Force One, Andrews, Crown is on, go ahead.
Crown?
Give Air Force One a call, please.
Roger. Air Force One, this is Crown, come in.
Air Force One, I read you loud and clear. I just had 373
process, all right? Would you call Sam Samantha and have him request two crash at four airplanes meet the airplane. We want two in the front of the airplane and two in the rear. Go ahead.
Air Force 180 is understand requesting two staff cars with air police, two in the front and two in the rear. Is that correct?
Measured on the cars, just the air police. We want security guards. We want four of them. Two at each door of the airplane, go ahead.
Air Force 1, Andrews, roger,
we'll
by Sam.
Roger, thank you.
Roger, AF1, AF1 from Crown. AF1 from Crown, come in.
Crown, AF1, go ahead.
Roger, stand by for a patch from Tanker.
Roger.
Hello, Angel.
May I speak with Watchman or Tiger? Watchman or Tiger, over.
Roger, Watchman is busy at the present time on another circuit. Stand by for Tiger.
Standing by for Tiger.
Tiger, how do you read, over?
5x5, Tiger, 5x5. I have been informed from Dallas that it was desired that the aircraft be parked in a isolated spot when you arrive here. However, Watchman had a long discussion with Behn, and nothing about that was mentioned. And the present plan on the ground here is to spot you at the regular place, unless the Watchman says now that this is not desired. Over.
I believe they want to park at the regular place, Tanker. Where did you get that information from in Dallas? Over.
It was from the USAF command post agent there, and I understood from him that you had told him to do this. Over.
Well, we told him to look into that, and in the excitement there, I guess he assumed that we wanted it done. We were going to discuss it in flight.
I see.
We should go ahead with a present plan and park in the regular place. I asked Hornbuckle to get in touch with you. I'll pass some instructions to him. We need steps on the right front of the aircraft. The press box will be on the left front of the aircraft. The President Johnson will deplane at the front of the aircraft. And we need a first lift at the rear of the aircraft. Lace will deplane on the right front. Over.
Understand, Tiger, those instructions, and they have all been carried out. We will continue with the plan to spot you in the regular place. There will be a ramp left front, a ramp right front, a forklift left rear, the press area left front. Over.
Very fine, and now we'll keep in touch.
Roger, thank you, and out.
I still have your patrol. Could you pass this to Wing? Pass this to Wing that on his message to Slugger, Slugger was still in Dallas, and has been advised to contact Wing as soon as he possibly can.
Roger, Air Force 1 copy, well passed.
Roger, Crown out for now. Do you have anything further, AF1?
Roger, stand by 1, we'll have another patch from Warrior.
Crown?
Crown on.
Yeah, go ahead, give Air Force 1 a call.
AF1, Crown, go ahead.
Okay, I need Capital 43121, extension 493. We'll talk to anyone there.
Say again, it was Capital 43291, extension 493.
That's 43121, extension 493.
Roger, understand. Anyone in particular there?
Roger, anyone at that number?
Roger, stand by. AF1,
AF1 from Crown, was that extension 493?
That is affirmative. Congressman Thomas is open.
Say again the Congressman's name, as they say they have no such extension.
It's Congressman Thomas, Tango Hotel Oscar, Mike Alpha Sierra.
Roger, stand by.
Congressman Thomas' office on the line.
Roger, this is the airplane. The Congressman is requesting that you place his door keys under the doormat of his residence. Go ahead.
Okay, hello?
Hello, did you hear me?
There will be someone at his residence.
I understand the house will be open and someone will be at the residence, is that correct? Hello, I understand that the residence will be occupied. Someone will be at home, is that right?
AF1, this is Crown. That is a Roger. She said that there would be someone at the residence.
Okay, fine, Crown. Thank you very much.
Roger, Crown out.
And Andrews, would you check on the current temperature there when you get a moment?
Roger.
The last message I got was they queried me as to whether a volunteer was aboard. Go ahead.
Stand by, Air Force One.
Go ahead, Andrews, Air Force. Fighter Command Post, Air Force 1, landed after the 2300.
Roger, Air Force 1, Command Post,
Zero 04, please.
Air Force 1, Andrews, Roger on the block, 04. Good day, sir.
Yeah, thank you.